But remember that there are two questions. I better now say, lest I be accused of not having exhausted the entire subject in my first response, I better say there are at least two questions. One is this: is there a God, a creator, a prime mover, an uncaused cause, whatever you like to call it? And this was the question answered at a certain point, not very long ago in our history, by the deists, people like Thomas Jefferson, Thomas Paine, and many others, who said that the order of the universe seemed to suggest that it couldn't just have been random, that there may have been a designer, but the designer didn't take any part in human affairs. And that, in the late 17th, early 18th centuries, late 18th, early 19th centuries, was probably a very intelligent position to hold. It was as far, pre-Einstein, pre-Darwin, was probably as far as you were likely to get with philosophical speculation. But so believing that there might be a cause or a mover or a creator is one thing, but believing that there is a supervising, intervening entity who cares who wins the war, who cares who you sleep with and in what way, who cares what you eat and on what day, and in other words, who makes you the center of the whole cosmos, is another thing altogether. So people who say, I believe in God, I'm a deist, have all their work in front of them before they can say that they are really religious.
Are you prepared to be a deist?
No.
No divine mover, even at the whatever, the origin.
There's nothing in the natural, in the cosmic order, or that's the macro level, or the micro level, that's to say the constituent of our own DNA and the things that we have in common with the other animals, and indeed other forms of life like plants, that isn't susceptible to a much better explanation.